So you got a passport. You got plenty of time until it expires. Are you good? Let's talk about it. Hey, what's up everybody? Tony with LidoLoca.com. Welcome to the YouTube channel. If you're new here and you're into cruise ships, cruise news, cruise tips, cruise vlogs, consider subscribing with the notification bell on, and that way you won't miss any of our videos. Today, let's talk about passports. Passports are easily the best form of identification to use on any kind of travel, not just cruising. So passports are definitely the way to go when you travel, but did you know that there are three times when your unexpired passport won't get you into the country that you're trying to get into? Now, before we talk about those three instances, let's just talk a little bit about passport expiration. First off, if you are 16 or older, you are considered an adult by the passport issuing body here in the US, and adult US passports are good for 10 years. Now, if you are 15 or younger, the passport that you get is only good for 5 years. That is significant if you're traveling with children. You may have plenty of time left on your adult passport, but if you've gotten passports for your kids to travel with you when you were younger, you just want to make sure that they're not about to expire because it's half the time of the adult passport. Now on to times when valid passports might not get you into a country. Number one does revolve around expiration dates. Many countries want to make sure that you have enough time on your passport validity before you enter their country. It's called the 6 month rule. Some countries apply it to when you enter the country. Your passport needs to be good for another 6 months. And some countries calculate it on when you're going to leave the country. A good rule of thumb is to renew your passport within 9 months of its expiration date. That takes all of these 6 month rules out of play. It really depends on the country that you're going to. So if you are going to a foreign country, make sure that you go to that website for the country and understand how valid your passport has to be. Because when you show up with your valid passport and there's only 4 months left and it doesn't qualify for their 6 month rule, you might be denied entry. The second example of times when your valid passport may not be accepted is when your passport is damaged. This could include your passport being torn, defaced in some way. I recently saw an article where a child had gotten a hold of their parents' passport and it colored all over it. When you present something that is damaged or defamed in that way, there's a good chance that your passport will not be accepted regardless of how much time is left on the expiration date. And the third example caught me by surprise. I hadn't even thought about this. Some countries require a certain amount of blank pages in your passport to enter into the country. So some countries will require a single page or more than one page to enter the country. A good rule of thumb is to always have 2 blank pages for each of the countries that you're going to enter into. But again, it's one of those scenarios where you need to look up information on the country that you're going to and determine exactly how many pages are required for you to get into the country. I did read an article recently of a traveler who'd gone to multiple countries, and when they got to their last destination, the requirement was that they had 2 pages to get into the country, and they only had 1 page left in their passport, and even though the passport was valid and it wasn't expired, they were denied entry to that country. Now, these are broad travel tips, but they also apply to cruising. Not every cruise port that you go to are going to stamp your passport or even require any space in your passport, but there's some that will. There's definitely some cruise ports that will take into consideration that 6 month rule. I know the Bahamas are one of them, and there are some countries that will mark your passport. When we went to Cuba, we had to have space inside of our passport. Again, it's one of those deals you want to check with your cruise line, check with the location that you're going to see what the requirements are. For me, I always thought, well, I've got my passport, it's not expired, I should be good to go. But yeah, there are a few gotchas. So here's the question for the comments. Have you run into any of these passport issues? Have you had a damaged passport or one that was about to expire that you didn't have 6 months on, or one that you didn't have enough pages? Leave a comment below. Let's keep the conversation going. Again, I'm Tony for La Lido Loca, and until the next time, we'll see you on the Lido.